You have an update.
You have an update on a story you brought us last year.
I do. So I don't know if you remember the story we did about a group of ice drillers. They were the Ice Drilling Design and Operations Group. They're based out of the University of Wisconsin. And the group designs and maintains large drills for the National Science Foundation for their research in Antarctica. And when we talked to them late last year, they were putting the finishing touches on their Agile Sub-Ice Geological Drill, which is also known as the ASIG drill. And it's going to be used for climate studies coming up. And this week, I was invited to see a full test of the drill before it gets sent to Antarctica later this year.
We have a 50-foot well here filled with ice. And at the bottom, we got about 6 feet of rock. And we're doing testing of both configurations, or both media, I guess. So we'll go through the 50 feet of ice and then do some rock, which represents what we'll be doing in Antarctica.
And what do you hope comes out of today's tests?
We're demonstrating that the rig is going to, you know, perform and finding any issues that come up before we get out there and have no resources. So, we'll make sure it works and make sure we know how to work it.
You ran into a little problem today with some of the testing.
Yeah.
What was that?
I guess we did. We just had this spring broke, and we're going to have to get it replaced. It won't take too long. We'll be back in business here pretty quickly.
And that's part of what holds the tubes in place?
Yeah, that's right. That's the foot clamp at the base of the rig there. It holds the tubes.
So drilling can't happen unless you have the spring, right?
Right, yeah. Okay. Just one spring, but we'll bring plenty of spares to Antarctica. We've been, as part of the testing, that's what we're trying to do, is identify what issues we have and fix them. And just daily fixing minor issues.
Everything's been minor so far. Everything's pretty much run as planned.
Well, you know, it's minor once it's behind you, I guess. And everything's working now, so.
It's minor here, but it would be major in Antarctica,
well,
I suppose.
For sure, yeah.
And since there aren't any hardware stores in Antarctica, having part of the drill breakdown could become a big problem. So the team will continue the testing until they're certain everything is working properly. And the drill is scheduled to be shipped to Antarctica in August and will be used in West Antarctica this coming December and January.
Bring extra springs.
Yeah, I guess so. They learned that lesson this week.
They did that testing right up in Stoughton.
In Stoughton, yeah, wow. Of all places. They have a hole there that they're able to use. It's 50 feet of ice, and then there's some concrete, and then they're able to drill into the granite that you saw, that tube of granite. And they think that that's a pretty good simulation for what they'll be doing in Antarctica, where they'll be drilling through about 700 meters of ice and then into the rock layers there.
Pretty amazing.
Interesting.
Yeah. All right.
Thanks, Karen.
You're welcome.